Now I've decided to use the velvet on the neckline, and I've just folded the neckline, the velvet over. Now a thing to bear in mind with velvet, make sure that the clutch of the velvet is going one way, so just feel for it. That's the rough side and that's the smoother side. So I'm trying to make sure that the smoother side folds downwards and it's softer to the touch. I'm just going to make the top of the dress exactly the same, and I'm not going to line the neck, I'm just going to cut around it. So I'm going to sew these two together and then just turn it over. So the right side size neckline, I'm just cutting this out on the velvet. Basically what I've got is a neckline. And that's how I'm going to be doing the neckline. Over here, I'm going to use that part of the border, so I'm going to cut this, and that I'm going to use as my centerpiece in there, and then use the smaller pieces. Just attach them on the sides and use these as the smaller pieces. The other thing that I'm going to do is use this kind of a fabric inside here as a trimming. And the other thing which I may do, I haven't decided on, is maybe use a little bit of this as a trimming just to go on top of that. So I'll decide on that, or I may just turn this over and just leave it at that. I'll just decide on what we're going to do with that. So on the hemline, I've got this. Just turn this over towards that side. This is the hemline, and for the hemline I have cut. This was a piece that was left over from the embroidery. So what I will be doing is using that. Now because the pattern doesn't come central, I may just add a little bit of a piece here. And then I'm going to be using this at the bottom. Does seem like a lot of work, but once we start it up, it shouldn't take too long. And then I'm going to trim that off with the velvet like this on both the sides, and the velvet at the top as well. At the moment it looks like a bit of a jumble, but we shall get to it hopefully quickly.